the screen, sir.
Just a moment, I'll take the TV. 11987G. Okay, now I will take my screen view, my screen, see, I'll share my screen. Start. Can you mute your mic?
It's already muted, sir.
Hello?
It's already muted, sir.
But you're speaking in the phone, huh? You're muted. Okay. I'm getting the echo, actually. Okay, let me try again. Are you, is it clear now? Aisha, is it clear? Yeah, you can speak now. Aisha, is it clear now? You can speak. Hello. Okay. Aisa, share your screen. Yeah, I can share your screen, Skype.
Hello?
Yeah, you share your screen in Skype.
Yeah, sir, 1 minute.
Yeah, start the packet tracer, this one, GNS3. Okay. Start. Take the consoles. Show me the notepad. So topology, if you see the topology, we have 182, 168, PC, one is 10.1, okay, default gateway 10.1, no IP address, correct, IP address is 10.2, okay, no shutdown, okay, ping 30.2, okay, and the IP PC2 also 30.1 default gateway, 30.2, the serial is 10.2, okay, go down. Yeah, R1 is now it has to ping, means we need to have a routing protocol, right? So we need to add some routing protocol in R1 and R2. After no shut, you are give exit and add routing protocol after no shut in R1. Routing protocol. Yeah, okay, exit after no shut. Exit, enter, router EAGRP 1. Okay, then network 0.0.0.0 space 255.255.255.255. No auto summary, exit. Okay, now yeah, okay, come down. Okay, in that only R1 only, what we will do after configuring serial IP address, IP. Okay, end, so IP route. Okay, next, same thing you copy paste in same command you copy paste in R2 also. I think it will work now. Let's see. Now copy paste in all four consoles and see that pinging. Yeah, start from PC1. There is an error. The error is IP default gateway command is not working. Something saying 255.255. Okay, try that command again. IP default gateway. Global mode, go to global mode. IP space default question mark. I think there will be no subnet mask actually. Question mark, question mark. Yeah, IP address, correct. Space, question mark. Yeah, that's it. So what you do in a notepad, remove the subnet mask in default gateway command, both even R2 PC2 also. Okay, now copy paste again PC1. Yeah, paste. IP routing correct, interface FHS also IP address no shut correct, ping response enter. Oh, still it is going on. Okay, PC2. Then R1, R2. D is coming. Okay, now come to PC1. Apparo key. Enter. Yes, success rate is 100%. Okay, working. That's it. Now what we learned is we have just made the basic ready, basic topology, the basic configuration, right? So you can share with everybody, other students also, the base config. So they can also use that. Next, what you're going to study is PPP and PPP chap. Now PPP means what? It's a L2 protocol. First of all, what is L2 protocol of LAN in this topology? Just show me the topology. And close the base lab, yeah. Base configuration and close. So what of all we are going to do is, yeah, correct. So what is the L2 protocol for R1FA00? Can answer, Saif, and you can answer. What is the L2 protocol? Okay. What about Saif? What is the L2 protocol for LAN? FA00. Layer 2. Yesterday we studied layer 1, layer 2, WAN technologies. In OSI model, which layer will change? Which layer protocols will change, right? So, what is the L2 protocol for LAN? FA00. Both are wrong. The answer is L2 protocol is Ethernet. The answer is Ethernet. L3 is IPv4. What is the L2 protocol? Ethernet. Understand? So how do you verify this? Go to the R1. Go to R1 and type command. Show interface FA00. R1, you are in PC, go to R1. Yes, so interface 0/0, you can see the encapsulation. ARPA means Advanced Research Project Agency, which is nothing but Ethernet, Ethernet version 2 or Ethernet. So the name given by Cisco is ARPA for Ethernet. So this is the L2 protocol. Mean L2, what are the protocols we have? Tell me what are the L2 protocols we have. One is Ethernet, another one is? Yesterday's diagram you can check. Yesterday I sent you some videos, some paint, you know. Yesterday video paint, you can check paint. That I mentioned you, clearly I given you what are the L2 protocols. Okay. I think it's in the WhatsApp, I think. In WhatsApp it is there. I will send you in the WhatsApp. I'll send you in the WhatsApp to Skype. Wait. And one more is So what are the L2 protocols we have? This is L2 is Ethernet. Yesterday I told you, right? L2 is Ethernet. L3 is IPv4. L4 is TCP. Yesterday discussion with you. Now we are going to do, okay, what is the default L3 protocol for Cisco routers? L2 WAN protocol for Cisco routers. What is the default L2 WAN protocol for Cisco routers? The answer is SDLC. The answer is SDLC. Now we are going to change the HDFC protocol to PPP. Okay, that is our lab today, first lab. First lab, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the HDFC to PPP. First of all, I need to know what protocol running, right? So how to check that? So interface serial 1/0. That will show me what protocol is running in my WAN. Serial 1/0. Yeah. What is encapsulation? Encapsulation is SDLC. Now I'm going to change the encapsulation to PPP. So how to change it? Go to the interface. So global mode interface is 1/0. Encapsulation space question mark. Tab scroll. Tab. Question mark. See, this protocol can support ATM, frame relay, SDLC, LAGP, PPP, something like, I don't know what is that, SMDS, and last one is X.25. These all are the L2 protocols, WAN protocols. Same way, you go and check in LAN also. Go to FA0/0 and check. Encapsulation question mark. Question mark. No, now it will not work. You have to put E question mark. So there is no command like encapsulation in global mode. So you have to go to preview other interface mode. Go to interface mode and try question mark. No, I were interface mode only, correct? So in fast Ethernet 0/0, you cannot change because that is fixed. But in WAN, we can select whichever protocol we want. So LAN is only one protocol, only one technology. Fast Ethernet is only for Ethernet. So you cannot change the encapsulation. In WAN, you go serial 1/0, you can change the encapsulation. Yeah, question mark. Yes, now which protocol we are going to use? Point to point protocol, PPP. The moment I give point to point protocol, enter, what will happen? R1 is point to point, R2 is SDLC. So the interface will go down. See, the interface down. What is down? Line protocol is down. Now if you verify this, control is that and show IP interface brief. Okay. Now actually if you see, we can see that status is up, protocol is down. status is up, protocol is down. What do you mean by that? The meaning is what? The meaning is physical layer is up, data link layer is down, L2 is down, L1 is up. So L2, what is down? Because L2, one side is PPP, one side is SGLC. That's why L2 is down, but cable, connector, all are okay. Cable, physical layer is okay. So go to R2 and change it to PPP, it will come up. Yes, now it is up. The next protocol what we are going to study is, understand, PPP is a family of protocols. PPP is a family of protocols. In that protocol, so many, PPP is a family name. In that, so many protocols are there. One of the protocol is authentication protocols. Authentication means both sides, R1, R2, will put password. If the password is same, then the link will come up. Otherwise, the link will not come up. For example, you are in R1. Okay, you are in R1. Aisha, can you increase the font size possible? Font is very small. I don't know how to see that. Settings. General. Yeah, fonts. I think we had last time we increased it. Okay. Color, generic, use system color, and appearance, and change, bold 14, okay. Session. Yes, default setting, click default setting. Yeah, save. Okay, now close, don't open, close, don't cancel, close, into mark, close, again launch PuTTY, and see the color, oh my god, it's not saved, again do it, appearance, bold italic. Okay. Sessions. Select, save. Again, one more time do it. Select and save. Default setting, select and save. Select, save, open. Okay, close it and try again. Let's see, it's coming. Yes, this time working. Yes, working, no problem. Working, color is changed. Close it. Close the full console and check again. Yeah, save it and close it. close full this one. Consoles, all consoles. And open the consoles, all consoles again. Okay, this is good. Now, there is a message is coming, duplex mismatch, something like that, right? I like to stop that message. How to stop it? Go to global mode, exit. And enter, no CDP run. Question mark you view. Run don't you, question mark you view. Question mark, you give an enter. Question mark, yeah, run is there, right? Run, no CDP run, correct, command is correct. Okay, enter. Yeah, now onwards, the message will not come. The CDP was running and CDP is telling some error is there, it's not mismatching or something like that. So I just stopped there, no CDP run. And so next, Cisco Discovery Protocol. It will discover some error is there, it will discover and tell you. And next, it is telling there is a mismatch in the configuration. There's a mismatch in the speed, duplex, simplex, duplex, half duplex, full duplex. There's a mismatch in the speed. So it was giving some message. So I don't want to use that. I don't want to suggest, ignore it. I ignored that message. That's it. So now I don't want to see that CDP message. I can stop the CDP messages. Okay, next I'm going for... yeah, go to that. Now I'm going to do it. PAPCHAP. Okay, what is PAPCHAP? First understand. PAPCHAP is nothing but PPP family is one of the protocol, authentication protocol. And what PAPCHAP will do is, it will create a password in both routers in WAN. And if the passwords are same only, your LAN protocol will come up. For example, in R1, create a user. Username, you are in R2, right? No problem. R2 create a user. R2 no problem. R2 you create. R1 go to global mode. Now here also we are getting that message. No, I want to stop it. What do I do? Here we stopped already. No CDP run. Yeah, we R2. So we are in R2. R1 also can stop if you want. Okay, good. Now I'll create a user here. Username. Tab use karo. Yeah. So here, who is coming and getting authenticated is R2. So your host name is username. So give R2. 22. Space. Password Cisco. Use tab. Don't type full command. Cisco. Enter. Now go to the serial interface and enable encapture, enable authentication. Go to serial interface. 1/0. PPP space. Question mark. Let's see what other commands are there. Yeah, authentication is there. Escape. Escape. Yeah, authentication. AUTHE. Tab. Now question mark again. Okay, here I'm going to teach you. There are so many protocols are there. We are going to study two protocols, PAP and CHAP. PAP full form is what? Password Authentication Protocol. Or you can write down like this. PAP means Password Authentication Protocol or Plain Text Protocol. CHAP is Challenge Handshake Authentication Protocol. Okay, So what is PAP will do is PAP will send as password as in a plain text. But if a hacker is there, he can download and see the password. So I don't want to use PAP. CHAP means to convert the password into a cipher text. It's called hash code. Then send it. So compared to PAP, CHAP is secure. So let us use CHAP. The moment you give CHAP and enter, again your line protocol will go down. Enter. Yes, your line protocol went down now. See the interface, line protocol is down. Now why it is down? R1, I gave you the password. R2, there is no password. Now the moment you go to R2 and give the password, the again protocol will come up. Go and give R2 password. Okay, R2, who is the user? Who is coming and authenticating? R1. So go to R2 and create username R1. Password Cisco. The link is down, right? Again, the link will come up after you give that. Enter. Yes, the link came up. Now enter. Now I will create this side also password and authentication. How to do it? Go to serial interface and add the authentication method. Go to serial interface, add the authentication method. PPP authentication space authentication. Chat. Now the link will go down. Again, we come back. That's it. Do not take more time because we already have that side. The link went down. Again, we have already have that side ready. No, it will come back again. Understand now? The link went down. The other side, we have all just checking it actually. The password is there. So authentication is done. You come back. So you understood this, right? This is called a PAP CHAP. Password is PAP is password authentication protocol. CHAP is challenge uncheck authentication protocol. Next, we are going to study PPP OE. So WR control is a WR. All four devices you save it. WR enter. Other side R1 also WR, R PC also WR. Okay, now let me start PPP OE now. This is the basics we studied about authentication protocol. The next protocol in the PPP family we are going to study is PPP OE. So, Aisha, you can actually remove the screen. I will share my screen now. So, PPP OE is something like a huge protocol which we are going to study. First, PPP OE. PPP OE is, as I told you, like PPP OE is used for broadband. In home, we have Airtel broadband, right? We have Airtel phone also, Airtel modem also will be there. So that time we use PPP OE. It's a broadband connection. We call it as remote access server, RAS connection, or broadband racks. We call it as broadband racks. Okay. Now, what is PPPoE is when you power on the modem or router, nowadays we call broadband router. When you power on the broadband router, what will happen? The router will start doing one communication. The communication is called, okay, you remember DHCP? Okay, what is DHCP process? Tell me. Anybody tell me how DHCP works? There is a process in DHCP. Can tell me? There's name for the process, how DHCP works. Aisha, you know the process name? DHCP, how it works? Okay, so I'll tell you first how DHCP works. What is DHCP? DHCP is dynamic host creation protocol, right? What do you mean by dynamic? Dynamic means automatically. You don't need to configure, automatically it happens. Something happens. Dynamic. So automatically it will happen. What will happen? It will happen to the host. What is host? Host may be a PC, maybe a router. Okay, maybe a router or maybe a switch. It's all called hosts. Hosts are anything which can process, store, any device which can process, store, and forward the data. That device is called a host. Okay. Next, configuration. What it is configuring? It is automatically configuring what? It is configuring IP address, subnet mask, default gateway, DNS server address, DNS address, like on the domain name. Like this, so many things it automatically configures in your PC. Domain name, then lease period. Whatever configured is not permanent. It is configuring only for 24 hours. 24 hours. That is called lease period. 4 hours. Okay, these all are called what? IP config. Then, protocol means set of rules. How to do it, how not to do it, like that. So it's called do's and don'ts. This protocol is followed worldwide. Okay, this is here. This is called a DHCP. Now, when you take a DHCP laptop, when you take a laptop and you connect to a DHCP server, what happens? Your client, this is called DHCP client, DHCP server. DHCP client. Then DHCP server. Okay, now first he will send it one message. Yes, now you are remembering. The answer is, first it will send discover packet. So it will send packet. This is called packet walk. DHCP packet walk. So packet, we are going to understand. First it will send a discover packet. It will ask anybody is having any offer. Is there? Can I use that offer? Then DHCP server will give an offer. The offer is something like this. My offer is IP address equal to .21. Then you will go for, once I get the offer, again client will say, okay, I got the offer. Shall I use that offer? He will ask, he will request. I got an offer from you. Shall I use that offer? Now, this guy will do what he will do. Server will do. Server will bind. For example, this client MAC address is 1111. Okay. What it does is it will bind binding table. It will bind the IP with the MAC address. Whatever MAC address is giving now. For example, say .21 I am giving to 1111. It will bind. After binding, it will give a reply saying that yeah, I have given to you this address. You can use it. It's acknowledgement. So this four-step process is we call it as DHCP DORA process. This is the way DHCP works. Understand? Now, same way here, I am connected to a. This is my house broadband router. Okay, I want to go to internet. Where I want to go? I want to go to internet. I went to an ISP. Now this guy is my ISP. Maybe Airtel. Okay, where I want to go? I want to go to internet. This is my internet, for example. Yeah. So I want to go to internet. So I went to ISP for the internet connection. Now ISP gave me a connection. So what ISP said is, okay, you connect to my internet, I will give you the connection. So here in the internet, in ISP network, he has one router, and my PC, my house, he is given one router. This is connected like this. So then he is connecting to internet, something like this. So this is my PPP OE server. Okay. Now this server will have lot of details. Now PPP OE client, my house. He is PPP OE client. Same server client architecture. Now this is my customer router. Customer broadband router, for example. Okay. Now he has given to you, Airtel has given you broadband router. So you are powering on that router. First, what it will do. And you are connected to your house PC. This is your house PC. And you are connected to your. Now I'm going to explain you what is the process between PPP OE and PPP OE is a client and a server, what they will communicate. Like how server client communication or DORA, like that there are communications are there. That is two stages is there. One is, this is PPP. Okay, one, discovery stage. Then second is session stage. Same way, in the discovery stage, what happens? One by one, I'll tell you. First, in discovery stage, he will request, like discovery, it will ask you what is the discover. Like, for example, see here, they've given you first discovery initiation, then discovery offer. Who will you offer? First initiation packet, client will send. Offer will come from server. Then he will ask, I got the offer, shall I use that offer? Then server will give the session details. Once you receive the session, client receive the session, then the client will terminate the discovery stage, then start the session. So that's why when you power on this broadband router, it will take a lot of time. Blink, 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 blink. Because that time what is happening? It is running three this. First is PADI. What is PADI? PPPOE Active Discovery Initiation. Okay, then second is PADO. PADO means what? PPPOE Active Discovery Offer. Then third one is I got offer. Now I have to request, right? PADR. PPPOE Active Discovery Request. Initiation, offer, request. Then last, what happened? Now he will give PADS. He will give the PAD session details. PPPOE session details. Then PATI. PATI means what? Terminate. What I am terminating? I'm terminating discovery stage and starting the session. So session stage starts. So understand this. This is the way PPP OE communication will happen. Are you clear on this? Aisha, are you clear? Then we'll go to next topic. Okay. Now PPP OE means first what? Try to understand this. PPP OE means what? I want to send. Okay, let us take this. First, I'll take a Ethernet header. Ethernet header format. I want Ethernet header or frame image. Yeah, I want. Let us take this guy. Simple guy. I want simple, 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 simple. कितना दिया है वो कितना नहीं चाहिए और सिंपल चाहिए अच्छा ओके या आई टेक दिस This is my PP Ethernet header format. You know this preamble and this one start starts frame delimiter destination address source address length and data size 1500 bytes. This is our MSS. Yesterday we studied na MSS and this is CRC. That's it. Now this is our format. Now what I am going to do? I am going to take this header. L2 header. Okay, put like I'm just bringing everything in a single format. It's called my L2 header. So L2 header. What is the size of L2 header? (clears throat) 14 bytes. Can you see that? The header is 14 bytes. Ethernet header. L2 header. Then I'm going to take the PPP header. What header? PPP header. This is my WAN encapsulation. PPP header. What is the PPP header size? That is 8 bytes. But when I take 8 bytes, what is my problem is? Whenever I am actually adding extra thing into Ethernet, Ethernet has a standard format. I cannot play with that format. So what is the maximum data size? MTU? What is Ethernet MTU? Aisha, Ethernet MTU. For Ethernet, what is the maximum data size? MTU. MPS. What is MBS? Yes, 1500, correct. There is no MBS, MBPS, that is speed. What you are telling is speed. Ethernet technology protocol MTU is 1500, correct. So this is mentioned here, see, 1500 bytes. Yeah, correct. So MTU, MBPS is megabits per second, that is for speed. My asking is this side, this is MTU. So now I'm actually adding in between 8 bytes. So what I have to do is I have to subtract my MTU to reduce my MTU. What is my MTU I have to give now? How much will be my MTU if I add 8 bytes? Minus 8 with 1500. How much I'll get? Yes, this is my MTU. So this is my PPP OE format. PPP OE header format. This is my PPP OE. So what is PPP OE if anybody asks you? I will take the data, I will encapsulate the data with PPP header because I'm going to send in WAN. I'm going to see Ethernet. This is L2 Ethernet head, oh sorry, L2 Ethernet frame. Sorry, I didn't return Ethernet. Ethernet frame. Okay, I'm using Ethernet protocol, but in between I'm adding PPP because I'm going to use for WAN, right? WAN protocol is PPP. PPP I'm using. But when I'm adding PPP 8 bytes, so I need to remove something. So I'm adjusting with my data MTU. So this is called a PPP OE header. If anybody asks you what is PPP OE means, PPP over Ethernet. for CPP over Ethernet. I am going to use Ethernet technology. If you say, if you see your house broadband router, what cable will be connected is Ethernet cable. Your router backside, you see what is RJ45 will be there. I'm going to use Ethernet technology for WAN. But WAN protocol is what? PPP. So I'm merging PPP over Ethernet. I don't want to give big connector. So I'm using Ethernet connector, RJ45 connector. So for that, I'm using PPP OE. This is PPP OE header. Are you able to understand this or not? Tell me. If you don't understand, explain to you again. If you have any doubts, ask me now itself. I'll go more deeper on this now. I'm going next level now. Okay, if you have any doubts. Okay, PPP is a WAN protocol. Is it clear? Okay, first clear. Now, Ethernet is a LAN protocol. Now, I am going to use PPP. I want to use PPP. I want to give WAN connection to all the houses. But if I go for RJ, this cable, serial cable, and this type of connectors, now, IDA35 connectors, big connectors, serial connectors, it's very difficult for them to connect and remove. Fixing will be very difficult. They want to make it simplified. So to simplify that, what they did, they took Ethernet help. So they use Ethernet technology in broadband, but Ethernet is a LAN protocol. We cannot use that for WAN. So what they did, they combined Ethernet also, PPP also. This is called PPP over Ethernet. So what is the benefit? The benefit is I can use Ethernet cable. I can use Ethernet connector, RJ45. Still, I can use that for WAN. That is called PPP OE. Understand? How to do that dividing? What do you mean by dividing? Where it is dividing? It is adding 8 bytes. So he needs space. No, he is sending Ethernet frame. He is actually sending an Ethernet frame. It needs 8 bytes space he want. So what it does is it takes from 8 bytes from MTU, from data. That's it. And what is your question, Aisha? Size is 14 bytes. Ethernet, it's mentioned here. Ethernet header size, 14 bytes. Where does it get L4? Oh, L4 will be added. After this, L4 will be added. L3 will be added first. After L3, 14 bytes is Ethernet header size. See, in real packet, how it will be there? If you want to put full packet size, I'll put it. You understand. First, L4 will come. L4 header. L4 header. Then next is FL4 header. What is the L3 header? Then L3 header, then L2 header. Then data. After data, L2 footer.
let me write down here. I take this place here. Okay, I take here. Wait. Yeah, please get this side. Okay, wait. Okay, now L3 header. L2 header. So what is L3 header? L3 header will be, protocol will be IPv4. Then L2 header. L2 header is Ethernet. Then data. So what I am going to do, in between data and Ethernet, I am adding extra one more header, that is called PPP for WAN communication. This is my PPP header. After PPP, we'll have data. Data, then footer. The footer is your CRC, redundancy. So this is my data. After data, data will be 1972 bytes. Okay, 972 byte data size. Then we have L2 footer. Now, this is how many bytes? 20 bytes. Okay, this is 20 byte again. This is 14 bytes. And this is 8 byte. This again 4 byte. Okay, any doubt in this? Are you understanding now the size? See, again, this is MTU. MTU means maximum size. It's not the every data will not have 1492. Okay, maximum size is 1492. Understand? It's called maximum transmission unit, MTU. It may start from 46 to 4500. Okay, this is the, okay, any doubt in this? Saif also clear? So now we understood now what is PPPoE. PPPoE is nothing but we are adding an extra header in the Ethernet frame. So we can use the Ethernet for WAN technology. That's it. Because Ethernet is for LAN only, we cannot use for WAN. So you have to use WAN and you need to encapsulate this WAN protocol. So the WAN protocol is PPP. So I'm encapsulating PPP. When I add PPP header, the problem is the size will be differentiation. So I'm borrowing 8 bytes from data field. Okay. So this is, that's what we call PPP over Ethernet. Clear now? Now, next what I'm going to teach you is how to configure PPPoE. PPPoE configuration is not simple as other configurations. So let us see how can I explain you this. It's a little bit complicated configuration. Okay, let us start first. This is server configuration. Then client. Then creating loopbacks. Then verify the client. Okay, let us start. First server. How to put server in this? Okay, let us keep that. Now, first, what I will do, I will create a BBA group, broadband access group. BBA means what? Broadband access. BBA group. The group name is customer. Inside that customer, I'll create a virtual template. Virtual template 1. Okay, and then I'll go to the virtual template and say your IP address is this, no shutdown. And this is the pool. What I'm creating? 1 IP address pool. If any client comes, your router is coming, your house router is talking to the client PPP server, right? That time the server has given IP address. WAN IP address. You will get a WAN IP address, no? That pool I am creating. After creating that pool, I will say the authentication, PPP authentication method is CHAP. What is call in? Call in means you can call back. Call in, call out, call back. Different way of calling. You have to call for authentication. Call in, call out, call back, like that. So I'm calling. So when you call, when you call, as a client, you call, you will get authenticated with what? CHAP. Okay. Next, once I create this, I'm going to create a pool creation. So I'm going to give the name of the pool, test pool 1. This is the range, 1.1.1.2 to 254. Then that's it. Then I will put username, I'll create the number of users. So in this case, in our topology, 2 users are there, R2, R3. So I'm creating 2 users, R2, R3. Then I will attach this customer in the physically, this all virtually we created, right? This all virtually we created, correct? So all these things I'm going to attach physically to your interface, fastethernet 0/0. Okay. I will draw this in a graphical format. The same configuration I will show you in graphical format. So you'll easily understand this. This is a little bit complicated, right? So what I will do, same configuration, I'll show it graphically now. See, you'll try to understand this. First, I'm going to create one VBA group. This is my group, VBA group. VBA group. What is the group name? Group name is customer. Okay. Inside this group, I'm going to create one virtual template. This is my inside the group. Understand this. So inside the group, I'm creating a virtual template. The virtual template is called what? Virtual template 1. Virtual template 1. Okay. Now inside this virtual template, I am going to put what? IP address, pool, authentication, right? See what I'm doing now? I'm configuring IP address, template interface. No, this is an interface, virtual template, it's an interface. For the interface, I have to give IP address. Virtual interface, not sub interface, virtual interface. It's called virtual interface. And now it's not physical, nothing is physical. So I didn't create anything physical till now. All I created, let me put like this. This is like a virtual interface. Keep like this. So I'll create an interface. To make it simplify, no? I'll create an interface called a interface called virtual template 1. In that interface, I will say something like this. Your IP address is this. Okay. And you are going to use the address pool. Address pool, what you are going to use is test pool. Test pool, right? Yeah, that is the name. Test pool. Okay. Test pool, comma. Then what I'm going to say, you are going to use the address pool called question mark test pool. Clear? Next, I'm going to say, okay, if anybody comes to log into this interface, I'll use CHAP. My authentication method is CHAP. All these things I'm configuring. Now, inside this, I'm going to create 2 things. One is test pool. What is the test pool? I gave test pool, right? But I didn't tell you what is the range. So I give the range. Another one is users. Who are my users? Who will come and authenticate? See, when somebody is coming authenticated, I need to have the user database, right? Usernames. This is the test pool. So test pool. Test pool. Okay. And this is the users. User and password, something like that. You can give. I'm creating. So test pool. What is the IP address range? 1.1.1.1.1.1.1.1.1.1.1.254. This is the range. If anybody comes and asks, I'll give this IP address. And who are all authenticated? R1. Password Cisco.
R1 Cisco, R2 Cisco, like that. These are my users. So who are coming, I will authenticate them with the this username and password. Is I able to understand now what I'm doing? Yes. So see, this same thing. Now all I did now, understand, this all comes under a group called customer. Now I'll take this customer and the last step, I will add this customer to physically. I will add this customer to physical interface. That is physical interface what? All virtual, right? So physical interface I'm going to add is FA070. That's it. Once I add to the physical interface, your server configuration is ready. So this is called a PPPoE server configuration. Okay, configuration in flow in a diagrammatic format. It's not a command format. In a diagrammatic format, I explained you. I think it will make you clear. Okay, if you are not clear on this, if you are clear on this, give yes. I'll go to explain you the client side format. Side side clear. Okay, good, very good. Good, got understand. So this will really help you. Now, after seeing this, you go back to the config to understand. So you're creating a group, template one. Inside the template, you're going, giving IP address, pool name, authentication method, and I'm saying what is the range, what is the users, and attaching it, physically attaching it. Now you're able to understand, right? Okay, next I'm going to client side. Client side, you see, here also something like that. First, I'm creating a dialer one. In the dialer one, I'm configuring IP address. Negotiate. Negotiate means you talk to the server, get the IP address. Like DHCP. You talk to the server, get the IP address. Encapsulation is PPP. Password is CHAP and password is Cisco. Good. And it belongs to dialer pool one, dialer group one. MTU is what size? What is the MTU? 1492. This is a question they'll ask. Why 1492? Why not? Why they are reducing the MTU purposefully? The answer you know already. Why we are reducing it? Because I explained to you beginning, explained to you why it is 1492. We identified that. So then I'm telling, boss, no problem. Your dialer list is one and permit IP. It's something access list like that. You configuring access list to that and permit it like access list and routing route. So what is the route you're going to configure? Default route. Any IP address, any subnet mask, go to dialer one. Understand? All these things I configured. Now I'm going to attach this dialer, okay, dialer one to physical interface in the client router. Client router. Okay. So I'm going to the client router. I'm saying enable PPPoE enable and PPPoE client use this dialer pool number one. That's it. You are able to understand this? Okay, now let us start. I'll do the same diagram. Diagrammatic format, I explained. If you don't understand, I'll make the diagrammatic format again. Okay, let us start. So first I'm going to create one dialer. Okay, this is client side, okay? PPPoE client configuration. I'll draw the diagram here. Maybe she may understand that. Let's see. PPPoE client configuration. Okay, now what is this? So here, I am going to create one dialer. First, I'm going to create a dialer. What's the name of the dialer? Dialer one.
What is
that? Dialer means when you swipe the card, you see the machine will dial. When you swiping machine is there, when you go to swipe the card, the machine will dial. You see that dialing, receiving, that is dialer. That is dialing, dialer. So you configuring a dialer. When you swipe the card, your machine dialer starts. It will dial to the server automatically. You dial. Not card details. Then you type pin number. When you swipe the card, you dial to the server, get the details and ask pin number. You give the pin number, then you get the authentication, right? So that is dialing.
So that dial same way, when you power on the client router will dial to the server. The switch server, PPPoE server. Okay, so that is dialer. So dialer one, name of the dialer is dialer one. Okay, so this dialer one, I am going to configure. Okay, now in this dialer one, first I am telling. Okay, let me write down here. Some basic things I am telling to the in the dialer, inside the dialer I am writing. I am telling boss IP address, no, you, I don't give IP address for this. This is again interface, dialer is what? Interface, IP address is negotiated. You negotiate with whom? Negotiate with the server and get the IP address. You remember in the server we create a test pool, one range. That you talk to the server and get that IP address 1.1.1.2, 1.1.1.3. Something you get from the whom? From the server. Okay, negotiate and get from the server. This is the first command. I'm saying negotiated. And encapsulation is, you know that encapsulation, what encapsulation we are doing for this? PPP. What is the encapsulation we are doing here? PPP, na? PPP. And, okay, pool is. Pool is chap, then pool group. Let me write down here. Before going to that, I want to clear this part. This is again, this is an interface we're adding. Okay, what is pool? Pool means group of IP addresses. We have different types of pool. We have what do you call? We have when you go to this IP address, right, this is called IP address pool. So I'm going to use this IP address pool. I should understand pool is group of IP addresses. Okay, now I'm going use pool one chap. I'm telling all these details. I'm telling him use what authentication is, what authentication you do, you do chap. Okay, and what is the pool you use? Pool one you use. Okay, all details I'm telling him, what pool to use, what authentication to use, you belongs to what group. There is a group called a dialer group. You belongs to what group? Your interface belongs to this group. Okay, let me write down here. I'll make one more box here just to make it clear. So I'll say you belongs to dialer group. This is the group. What is dialer group? Why I am creating a group? I'll tell you one by one. There is a dialer group. First in dialer group one. Then I am saying you belongs to dialer pool one, dialer group one. I think MTU you can understand. What is IP MTU, you know? MTU, both of you can understand, right? Okay. I think you can understand that MTU. Okay. Then we have, that's it. So now we exit. Then we'll say you belongs to access list is permit any. Permit. Okay, done. Now, what is dialer group? Dialer group means in real time, we may have 2-3 dialers. How many dialers? 2-3 dialers. In even your swiping machine, right? Primary will dial. If primary fails, secondary will dial. If you observe that, first time, first fail happens, secondary dial will start in your swiping machine also. Primary, then secondary dial will happen. First primary fail, no, secondary will dial. Same way, I can create multiple dialers. So then I'll put everybody in a single group. Then that group, no, I will attach to the physical interface. So whenever you power on the, when you power on the your client machine, okay, it may dial first. If dial fails, dial one fails, dial 2 will do, dial 3 like that. That's why he says you belongs to group 1. Okay, he says that you are in group 1. In real time, we can create 2-3 dialers also. So we say everybody in one same group, then we'll attach that one group to then access list. We call dialer list here. What we call this? Dialer list and permit IP. Okay. Then IP routing. Route I will give IP default route. So default route is what? Any. Go to dialer one, interface dialer one. It is just saying, boss, you want to go anywhere, please go to dialer one. So dialer will take wherever it takes, no? You take there, you go there, no issues. So dialer one will take you wherever you want to go. This is the route. I think you're understanding this. Route is done. Then finally, last time, what I will do, I will again, same concept here. After configuring all these things, I will go to this and I'll attach this, physically attach this to one physical interface, because it's all virtual, nothing is physical. So I'll go and attach to that is default routing here, 0000. You remember static routing, dynamic routing, in static default network route, host route, default route. You remember? Okay. Fine. So now we'll go to 16. Attach physical interface FA 0/0. Understand? This is so you have to attach. Finally, you have to attach this. Clear on this? Any doubt? Now client is clear. Okay, Saif said okay, guys. Okay. Now after this, what I'm going to do? One more something is there. I'll show you that also. After this, I am going to create in the client side loopback, server side also loopback. Why? Because in real time we'll be having real machines, but here we don't have real machines. So we are going to use it in your real time in your house. No, the laptop will be there. That will get 192.168.1.2.1.3 some IP address. But here we don't have, so we are, how do we test it? So we are going to create a virtual interfaces in both sides for testing purpose. Then you remember, right? When you go to public to private, you need to do NAT. So we are going to use NAT for that. So first I'll go to server side. What I will do, I will create a loopback interface for testing. Let me write one here. Okay, I'm going here, I'm adding a loopback interface L0, that is 8.8.8.8. For why I'm creating this? For testing. So I will ping this interface. So I know that I'm able to go to internet. In real time, you ping internet directly. Here I'm just for testing purpose. I'm using it for testing purpose. Understand? No. People understand this? Same way I am here going to create one loopback. Loopback here it will be private IP address. Loopback will be private. The private will be 192.168.1.1 something like that. You understand? No. It must be private IP address. That is public IP address for self testing. And after this loopback, I will configure PAT. Inside outside. Create a list of the 1.1.0 network you add and say PAT overload. So you know PAT. I saw no PAT, right? I saw no what is PAT. She didn't study it at all. She was absent. NAT PAT. Okay, that day also I explained you, last class also I explained you that PAT, private public translation. NAT I explained you. Remember NAT? You remember NAT or not? I explained you. NAT, you explained. Correct, correct. Same thing only. NAT only, Pat. I'll explain you now. You understand NAT, right? Then this is nothing. Just NAT only, there are three options are there. I'll show you. Okay. Next level of artificial intelligence. All right. I say I can go through this blog. I will share this blog with you. You can go through this blog. I have made lot of diagrams in this blog, and it will be useful for you. I have lot of videos also there. I have given the complete our this list of videos. Playlist is there. You can go and check all the playlist. Even our classes also added in this. Our classes also added in this. All are added in that. So you can use this as a. I want to show you NAT. Yes, see now. Now here, NAT means what? Private IP address, public IP address translation. So when I give one private IP address, one public address is NAT. So in the three types is there. Static NAT is one private to one public. Dynamic NAT is I'll create list of users like 10.0 network and pool of IP addresses. So anybody comes in the IP address, I'll translate it. That is, this is called a dynamic, automatic. Now PAT means you know what? List of users, but I'll select one interface. So port address will be changed. Public address will be same. So for example, 1.2 is coming. 63.1.1 will be there. Even second IP address also 6.1.1 will be there, but the port number is changing. 1024, 1025, 1026. This is generally used for our broadband internet. Are you able to understand this? What I'm saying? Generally, NAT means network address translation. But here, what we are doing is we are actually translating with the port number because I'm getting only one IP address. Public IP address only, one IP address I'm getting. So I'm going to say that is this concept is used here now. PAT we are used. So we are used PAT. Now let us write down that also in this. So let me write down here. So what I did, the client side, I'm configuring loopback done, then PAT also. So PAT. In fact, what we are doing inside outside, which interface is inside, which interface is outside, I'm telling. Then I'm creating a ACL group one group list of users I'm creating. Then I'm saying PAT. What is mean by PAT? PAT is something called overload. The word I use overload. Overload means what? I am adding one IP address, so many port numbers. What do you mean by overload? Only one IP address, but different. I'm going to use only one IP address for all the private IP address. The word is called overloading the IP. Generally, one IP for one public IP, one private IP. No, that is normal. But if I take only one public IP and add all the private IP to that, then we call this as overloading that public IP. So the command itself, you see, we call the word is called overload will be there. Overload means nothing but we are actually adding the. Okay, this is our configuration. Now what I will do, I will try to. Okay, let us do this. Now we need to open GNS3. I'll take only two routers. One. The name is PPP. PPP OE. Okay. 37 then R2, then one switch, I'll connect this. Okay, that's it. You can take one more R2 also. This is my PPPoE server. This is my PPPoE client. Anybody created this notepad, something you created? Anybody created notepad? Aisha created notepad? No. Okay, I'll create now. I'll copy paste. I'll topology. Okay, I'll just show you the notepad now. I'll just do it, 2 minutes. I'll create a notepad. So I'm going to global mode R1. Let us start from R1 first. R1, I'm going. First, I'll go to configure terminal. Then I'll take this command BPPoE global mode. I'm going to BPPoE customer I'm creating. Then virtual template I'm creating. Right. Then I'm exit. Next, I'm going to create a virtual interface. Interface IP address I'm giving. Any mistake, you tell me. Okay. Then I'm giving no shot. Same interface, I'm adding which pool it will take the IP address. Okay, which pool to take the IP address, default pool, and what is the authentication also. The same interface I added. Then I will create a pool now. Now I need to come back, right? This is actually global mode. We have to come back, means exit you have to give. Right, I came back to global mode now. I created a pool. Name of the pool is test pool. Then I created users. R1. Then R2 and R3, two users. R3 not required because only one now. I'm only using one router, so R2 is enough for me. And finally, I'm going to add this to. Guy, and what is this interface? This is the interface I'm adding. This is the BBA group. Finally, no shot. Okay, now R1 done. Now, apart from this, I'm going to create loopback also in R1 or loopback. And R1 is client. Something wrong here. Okay, R1. This is supposed to be in client, right? Client is R2, correct. So then R1, I'll create just one virtual interface. Correct, that's it done. Then I'll create a virtual interface. I'll give no shut and exit, then create a virtual interface. The virtual interface also will give IP address. That's it.
I'll give end. Okay. So my R1 is ready. So what I'm doing in R1? First, I'm creating a VBA group. Name of the group is customer. Virtual template I'm creating. In virtual template, I'm saying the IP address, no shutdown, what pool I'm going to use, test pool. Then authentication is tapped. Then I'm creating the pool range. What is the pool range? And who is the users who can authenticate? And I'm adding that to physical interface, attached to the physical interface. That's it. Then I'm creating a virtual pool. This is my R1. Okay, clear. Let us go to start. Okay, next, I'll create R2 also. R2 is client, right? So client, first I'll create dialer. R2, I'm going to create dialer. So it's an interface. So I'll go to global mode. Global mode, then I'll give dialer. Then IP address negotiated. So whatever IP address you want, you please take from the server. Negotiate and take from the server. That pool is for server. Here we are using is, I'm telling you, take from server. That's it. You negotiate, take from server, encapsulate is PPP, and you belongs to dialer pool, this pool, and this is your group number. You belong to this group, and your MT use this. That's it. Then exit. Okay. Now I finish dialer configuration. Then I'll say you belongs to a dialer list 1, and I allow you. This dialer list is nothing but access list. So access is permit. Permit means permit anything. IPU permit anything. And the routing also. Route also no problem. Anybody want to go anywhere, please route to dialer 1. Then I will go physically add this interface to FA0/0. First, I'll enable the PPP for that. Once I enable PPP, then I'll add the client to this guy. Done. Next, I will go to here R2. I'll create a loopback first. Then I'll use your IP address. Enter. Then I'll give exit. I want to exit here also first. Exit. Here also exit. Then I will go and create the pack command. So for pack, I will say first you belongs to FA0/0 belongs to inside. Exit. Dialer belongs to outside. Dialer interface is outside. Exit. Then access list 1. IP access is standard 1. And what is the range? I'm going to permit 1.0 network. 192.168.1.0 network. So I'm doing just saying permit. Anybody? You know the wildcard mask, right? Then I'm going to say IP load and network. That's it. This is my done. So this is my configuration in R2. Let us try this both. I have doubt. It is 3745. No, it may not support our PPP OE. 3745. Let us try this. It doesn't support, we'll go for 3200 only. It will support, but if it doesn't support, for example, let us take the console now. Still R1, still R2 is not coming.
R2 yeah, came. Okay, now let us copy paste this first. R1 copy paste. Let's see what happens. Copy, enter, I click. Okay, ready. Then R2. Somewhere if you do any exit, no, it will not work. First itself error, so much error. Gaya. What is the error? I told you, no, this guy may not support. So he don't have dialer spelling mistake. No, I think so. Don't have configure. Terminal interface key question mark and a dialer. The okay, mistake, spelling mistake. Eh? D-I-A-L-E-R, correct? Eh, D-A-I-L, yeah. Spelling mistake. Okay, correct. Kar denge. D-I-A, either Kali, either mistake. Spell correct, na? D-I-A. No, wrong, either wrong. Dialer is the wrong. That is the mistake. With the wrong, either DAI hai. That's what is giving error. See, some reason has to be there, no? DAI hai, dekho. DAI hai, bhai. That's why it is error. I'm changing to DIA.
Go to the question mark.
Showing here, no? Error. Right? Let me do it again. It will work. Now let's see. Copy. Here again one more error. FA0/0 fast Ethernet spelling mistake. So Ethernet mein what is the spelling? E missing. Ethernet or FA0/0. I'll remove all this story. I don't want this. So this small mistakes you need to correct first time. Next time it will be working nice. Wait. Spelling mistake. Okay. I didn't copy properly. Copy. Now I'm going to give. I click. Nice. Super. Ready? Yama. Okay. PPPOEABC. Done. End कर दो last में. End कर ping. 8.8.8.8. I'm able to ping 8.8.8. That's correct. Now exit. End. Ping. 8.8.8.8. Zero, yeah, very successful. Very success means you are master in PPPoE. Then it will not success in first time. You need to troubleshoot. Okay, let me tell you what is the error. R1 same error. R1 what same error? Where is error in R1? Oh, there is an error. See, she has found it. That good. let us go to R1. What is the mistake? Authentication error is there. Where anything else? Only authentication. Let us try that. So, what is the error? Authentication. Sorry.
C-A-T-I-O-N.
Okay. Let us try it. Okay. Copy. Okay, done. Now let us see. No. Okay. So IP interface brief. Virtual interface, this IP address has to come. This IP address has to come. Dialer IP address has to come. Virtual interface, one IP address is unassigned. With your IP address, na? Where is the IP address? Oh, okay, we're not given. Virtual interface, okay. Let us go to R1, what is the error, we'll see. So IP interface. Virtual template is down. Why down? We are not given no short one for that guy. Yes. So we missed no short one for virtual template. We are given no short one. Why still it is saying down? It's not added to added. It is the error.
Sir, what is this? P is called IP address.
Send message. It's not understood. PPPOE and So virtual template is down and so access is not complete, no problem. Template is down, let us see what is the issue and anything else. Okay, what we can do is we can actually see what is happening inside. So debug command, let me see that is there in the presentation. Yeah, the command is debug PPPOE events, debug PPPOE, right? Authentication, debug PPPOE and negotiations. This all will show us exactly what is happening in the router. So the first option, I'll try this in R2, PPP, debug, PPPOE, the events. Now it will tell me exactly what is the problem. PPPOE events, then PPPOE, PPP authentication. Then PPP negotiation. Okay, now we will come to know exactly what is happening, why it is not working. We can find out if you see that it is sending PADI. What is PADI? Initiation packet is sending. So it is not receiving any offer. The maybe I am just thinking like there is a problem in the server. It is sending initiation packet, but it is not receiving any offer. I say, everybody understand this? Good. So this is very important. See, troubleshooting is one of the important thing in CCNP level. In CCNP level, we need to break our head and find out why it is not working.
and we need to solve the solution also. We cannot say I don't know. We need to find out. So as per I am actually that's why I'm doing in front of you only. Okay. Now I will first thing what I will do. As per my experience, I will remove this switch. Sometimes this guy, no switch, no, he may create an issue in me. I don't want the switch. I will delete this guy. Delete. Yes. Then I will take direct connection here. I'm just trying this option, okay? And the ports are FA0/0 to 0/0, correct. So the ports are same, right? We have taken. Let us see. What port we have taken? FA0/0. R2 also. FA0/0. Right. We have taken the right ports. No issues in the port. Now let us go back to that and see. In R2, we are getting any thing. Okay. So IP interface brief. Yes. Now dialer is up. Loopback is up. Fast Ethernet is. Oh my God. Fast Ethernet is say administratively down. They are not given no shutdown for fast Ethernet. What nonsense. Where is this guy? Oh my God. Here we didn't give no shutdown. No shut. Okay. That is the error. Let us try it one more time. Copy. Yeah. Yes. Chappu chappu papu chappu. Everything is coming. Now you can study what is this story. All papu chappu paddy. Paddas. See paddas came. Yeah, see chap will come somewhere. You can see chap. After see success. Yes. Password is success. Good. Chap ho gaya. Now starting. Face is finished ho gaya. So but now session details came. ICC came. Now session state closed. Listen starts. Now I got some IP, negotiated IP. See, I got the IP address. State got open. Now we will check who. So IP interface brief. Okay, come. Again, dialer one. This is important. This address you need to get. This is negotiated and got the address. Are you able to understand this? Now, bingo. No. The switch was not problem. The problem was interface was shut down. FA0/0 shut down. Switch is not the problem. The issue was interface was shut down. Switch was not the problem. Switch is not the issue. Okay. Now see what how I find out this. I debugged it. I understood PADI is going. PADO is not coming. There is no offer coming. So the beginning itself it is stopping. So what is the issue? PADI is going, but there's no PADO. So PADI is not going out. So where is the issue? Maybe switch or that interface, that cable, you know, beginning itself is an issue. So we can find out exactly where is the problem. So I got all the details now. Okay, that's it. We are finished today. PPPOE completed. So you can also try this and if you have any doubts not working, we will troubleshoot on next class. So next class will be frame relay. Frame relay, first I'll teach you point to multipoint, then I'll teach you point to point. So frame relay is a very big topic and same way I will also do it. I will do it like this. Then you can try in your home and you can show me if it's not working. Working, no problem. Okay, I will send you this notepad. I actually recommend you to create your notepad. What I am suggesting you is you create your own notepads. Actually, I will not send it, but still just for testing purpose. If you know, testing purpose or comparing configuration purpose, you can keep this notepad. Okay, but I suggest you to manually type each and every command. I suggest you manually don't copy paste. Manually type each and every command, then only you will learn. Okay.
then only you can troubleshoot. Fine. So I'll give this PPP way notepad, no issues. So says that's it. Now we can save up the thing. Okay. Skype, where is this? Touch file, add file. Let's stop. Okay. This diagram you will not get anywhere. Please keep this very important diagram. How it is, I explained you graphically, right? This is very difficult to, I keep it safely somewhere. If you have, whenever you have doubts, you can use this diagram. I will actually put this diagram in my, I'll create a blog now. In the blog, I'll start putting these diagrams. Because these diagrams are very important diagrams, which will make you understand how it works. Okay, thank you very much for listening. See you on Friday. Tomorrow is week off. So Friday, 7 o'clock, we'll meet for frame delay. Okay, thanks. Good night. Take care. Good night. Chalo.